It's in crisis, family of partitions. The point is that we want to introduce new topology, such that element of these partitions are exactly balls in this metric. This is possible, and this was idea of Dyson, who introduced his model. So, how to do this? For instance, on the semi-axis, you may consider family of dyadic semi-open intervals. They do not intersect. So you have to take semi-open intervals. And then you introduce distance between two points as a minimal, as a length, for instance, of minimal dyadic interval, which contains these two points. One can check that this is metric. And even so, this is a more strong metric. This is ultrametric. That means the distance between x and y less or equal than maximum between dxz and dzy. So this is so-called ultrametric inequality. And then one can check that balls in this ultrametric are exactly dyadic intervals. Okay, so different people came to this idea from different points of view. From physics, Dyson and Anderson, they built some theory of ferromagnetics with big particles and small particles and tried to define evolution of the system. Some people from probability, from theory of stochastic processes, also studied similar things. For instance, Lawler and Vios, they and many others, they studied shuffling methods of infinite desk of cards. Okay, so they constructed special random walk. And this random walk, this is actually infinite symmetric group. And this infinite symmetric group, this is union of increasing family of classic symmetric groups. So they said, I define the following random walk. With certain probability, I choose size of my deck. And then I apply some method of shuffling of this deck. So this is step one. And then they repeat the same. So this was a random walk. So these people, and myself in particular, they try to solve problem, recurrent, transient random walk. Okay, so if you start from some position, could you come back to this position for a finite number of steps? This is classic question in theory of random walks on groups. And here we actually deal with discrete, infinite group, infinite symmetric group. Well, there were many papers, and actually there were also questions, could we find transition probability of this random walk, could we estimate this interesting subject, because if you know, if you have some knowledge about transition probability or Green function, you can say many things spectrum of the generator of this random walk. Well, you can estimate many probabilities, interesting probabilities. So this is a very important question to somehow estimate transition probability in n steps. Once I did a talk in Bielefeld about this subject, and in my talk, Professor Molchanov, he became very interested, and he said, well, you know what? I introduced this class of operators many years ago. And he started to explain me that this was Dyson model, and he studied not random walk, but he studied evolution of this random process, Dyson's random process. So that's how we become collaborators. And Grigorian, Alexander Grigorian, he is a great expert in heat kernel theory. So transition probabilities. So that's how we started to study this subject. Okay. But also there was another point of view. Vladimirov and his collaborator, they said that, well, you know what, if we choose as a state space Euclidean topology, then this quantum mechanics is not very good describe some questions in quantum theory. So it would be more natural to replace the phase space by some semi-discrete structure. And they propose it instead of Rn, use Qn, where Q is a set of periodic numbers. This is well-known story, and they work in Stiklov Institute, and there are also people in Kiev, Kochubey, which are interested in these questions. So this was another point of view. So, and everywhere it was interesting to study Hamiltonian, L plus V, where L is a generator of the corresponding, I would say, Dyson Markov process. So this paper, this is the second paper of ours. So in the first paper we considered V locally bounded potential. Because potential is locally bounded, then the set, the domain of L is contained in the domain of V. So it becomes easier to study such an operator. But this is the second part where we admit non-bounded potential, such as, for instance, here. You see, the norm is periodic norm. This is periodic norm. And we consider here our operator on the set of periodic numbers. And L, this is so-called fractional derivative in the set of periodic numbers. First introduced by Tableson and then studied by Vladimir. And, well, we studied the spectral properties of this operator. So this is paper. Let me give you a few results in this subject. So, for instance, how we can define hierarchy of Laplacian L. So we consider metric space endowed with ultrametric. As soon as we consider ultrametric, then topology becomes very interesting. All balls, all open balls become closed sets. And any two balls is a any two balls of the same diameter is a coincide or do not intersect, like dyadic intervals on the semi-axis. So this is one can prove that having ultrametric we deal with totally disconnected metric space. So there is set of balls, and there are small balls, there are big balls, one can build trees of balls. So this is hierarchy. And hierarchy gives you horocycles of this tree. And then using this tree, one can build operator. So to build operator, we need the set of balls and hierarchy. By the way, this is useful definition. We say that ultrametric space is homogeneous if group of isometries acts transitively and preserves the measure. So for instance, this example with infinite symmetric group. So the volume of the ball is a number of elements. So all balls here are symmetric groups Sn and its left cosets. You see? So this example of homogeneous ultrametric space. And then immediately theorem, very interesting theorem, which is due to Del Muto and Figa-Talamanca. Well, it's very non-trivial theorem. So any homogeneous ultrametric space can be identified with certain locally compact abelian group, equipped with translation invariant ultrametric and Haar measure. So, for instance, dyadic intervals on the semi-axis, if you build this tree, you see, each ball has two small sub-balls, each small has two smaller sub-balls, and so on. This tree can be identified with tree of, with tree generated by two odd numbers. The same tree. So one can identify this ultrametric space generated by two odd intervals and the set of two odd numbers. It is very convenient. It is very convenient because of homogeneity assumption. We become some operator on group which is translation invariant. Okay, and the corresponding, if you prove that this is Markovian operator generator, then this will be processed with independent increments. So this is a very simple situation. So hierarchy of Laplacian. So to each ball, you associate some coefficient. This is so-called coefficient function. This function should satisfy some condition. They are written here, you see. And then you immediately define. This is example of such a function. Very good example. Instead of power alpha, you can take any decreasing function, by the way. So, as soon as you have family of balls, and you have a coefficient function, you immediately define Laplacian. You immediately define operator as a sum of elementary Laplacians. This is Poisson Laplacian of simple Poisson process. Okay, and B of X, this is family, this is geodesic on the tree of balls. This is family of balls which contain X and decrease to infinity. So this is, one can show that this operator is minus Markov generator. Minus Markov, it generates a Markov semigroup. Well, that's what we should prove. This is theorem. But moreover, you can prove that this operator has pure point spectrum, and each eigenvalue has infinite multiplicity. So pure point spectrum, and one can find explicitly eigenfunctions of this operator. They look like this. You see, B and B prime are two neighboring balls. And then one can change ultrametric. It is usual thing in theory of heat kernels to give good estimates of transition functions, of transition function or heat kernel, you have to pass from original metric to the so-called intrinsic metric. In Riemannian geometry, you have to use Carnot-Cratadori metric. Okay. So this is a metric which we can build using eigenvalues of this operator. And then this is ultrametric, of course. And then one can prove very nice heat kernel bounds and green function bounds. For instance, green function can be estimated as following. And this is volume function. Now, so let us pass to Schrödinger type operators. The case of locally bounded potentials, well, this operator is good defined for the case of locally finite functions with compact support and so one can prove there is no question with domain, and one can prove that this is symmetric operator. So one can prove very nice theorem. If V is locally bounded, then the operator H is essentially self-adjoint. So strange situation. Very general result, because in classic case, you need lower bound to prove essential self-adjointness. This is famous Sears theorem. And moreover, this theorem is very precise, because if this property does not hold, then one can construct examples of non-essential self-adjoint operators. And okay, so that's what we have with this nice Laplacian. And some analogous of classic results. If potential go to infinity, at infinity, then the operator H has a compact resolvent, so its spectrum is discrete. Well, if potential goes to zero at infinity, then essential spectrum of H coincides with essential spectrum of L, which is pure point, known precisely. This is good. And so spectrum of H is pure point, and there are maybe negative eigenvalues, but they have finite multiplicity, okay? So this is a situation where potential is locally bounded. As soon as we don't have problems here with dense domain of definition of this Schrödinger type operator. But if we want to consider non-locally bounded potential, then we really have a problem. Then we really have a problem. And with domain of this operator, so to define this operator, we have to pass to quadratic forms. We have to consider quadratic form, and then we have to prove that it would be useful to prove that this form is semi-bounded, symmetric, closable, and then it is associated with some self-adjoint operator. Okay? To prove that this operator is essentially self-adjoint, we have to prove that domain of this form is exactly this set. So, and already this is hard problem. So let me give you a few results on this subject. So for instance, if we assume that V is non-negative, 5 minutes, this is okay. If we assume that potential is non-negative and in L1 locally, then the quadratic form defined here is a regular Dirichlet form. So it is non-negative. And regular, that means that the set of compactly supported special functions generated by, for instance, eigenfunctions of operator L forms a core. So it can be any continuous function can be approximated uniformly and in the energy norm. Okay? So in this case, actually, we immediately obtain that our operator associated to the quadratic form associated some self-adjoint operator. We have this representation, and this operator is essentially self-adjoint. Well, this is quite the proof is quite involved. So we have to work hard and to prove some things. Unfortunately, I don't have time to comment on the proof. So let me pass to another theorem of this kind. When potential is not non-negative. And this is interesting question. So we say that potential is in Lp plus L infinity is if it can be decomposed in two parts. First part is in Lp and second part is in L infinity. So this is theorem. Let us consider the set of periodic numbers as a state space. And let us consider fractional derivative of Vladimirov and Tablisov. This is multiplier which can be defined using Fourier transform. One can read all these things in this paper, in ArcSiv, if you have desire. Then with such a potential, we can prove that the form Q is densely defined, closed and bounded below form. Hence, it is associated with a bounded below self-adjoint operator. And of course, this operator should be essentially self-adjoint because the set in this intersection is the core of this form. There is special case and special question. When the domain of H coincides with domain of Tablisov and Vladimirov multiplier. This is interesting because the domain of this operator can be described using Fourier transform. So this is condition. Here it is written. Okay, and now I want to, 1 minute. So there is case where potential can be negative and Lp plus L infinity does not fail. But we can prove that H is positive semi-definite operator. This is Hardy inequality. This is inequality which is known in classic case. So in this case, one can prove Hardy inequality and consider operator with negative potential. And to prove that spectrum of this operator is in semi-axis. Okay, thank you very much.
Questions?